Hey friends!
Hey friends!
Hey friends! It's me, Alana. Welcome back to my channel.
You are all sunflowers in a world full of weeds.
Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. It is me, Alana. For this video, I am going to be telling you all what I will be reading in September. So I have a good stack of books here that I will be reading or trying to read in September, mostly because I'm taking part in 3 readathons. So the first book I have is One of Us is Lying by Karen Ann McManus. I pulled this for my fall TBR and I put this immediately on my September TBR because I figured it would be super exciting to read and it'll get me in the mood for October. So I'm super looking forward to reading this. The next book I have is A Reaper in the Gates by Saba Tahir. I also am super excited to read this. I couldn't wait and I had to throw it in to my September TBR because I literally am so excited to jump into this book and see what happens next. And I'm excited because this is the last book I need to read before being caught up, before the last book comes out in December. And then I can actually say I officially finished a series this year, so that's also exciting. I'm just excited to see what happens next to my babies, because I feel like it's gonna wreck me at some points and maybe hopefully bring me joy at some points, but we shall see. The first readathon I'm gonna be taking part in is Monsterathon, which is created by Kate from Chapter Kate, and there's a bunch of other people who are gonna help host the teams. It's all month long. I am on Team Haunts, and so there are 4 prompts I basically have to complete. The first one is Under the Bed, a book by a Black or Indigenous author. For that one, I chose Legendborn by Tracy Dion because I am so excited to read this month, and yeah, I'm just super excited. And she's Black, and the main character is Black, so it's just full of Black magic, basically, and we're here for that. The next prompt is Secret Crypt, a mystery book / book with a mystery element, and for that one I chose When No One Is Watching by Alyssa Cole. This is my first Alyssa Cole book. I think this is her first thriller, so I'm really excited to check it out. This is my first adult thriller, so I'm also excited for that too. But I've heard really good things about it. I know it touches upon gentrification, and so I'm intrigued to see how that is tied into this thriller. And the next prompt, A Moment of Peace, a comfort read. So for that one, I chose The Inheritance Games by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. If you haven't watched my 3 previous videos, I talk a lot about this book. I'm really excited to pick it up and read it because Jennifer Lynn Barnes is one of my favorite authors, which is why I chose this to be my comfort read, because I just want to dive into a new world and just back into her writing. And so I'm super duper excited to be able to do that this month. And then the last prompt is Your Friendly Neighbor's House, a book chosen by a friend. So I chose A Song of Wraiths and Ruin by Roseanne A. Brown. I chose this because it's going to be Chanel's book club, the Crusty book club's pick for September, and I'm helping co-host that actually with her. So technically she chose the book, so this counts for that prompt. Also, going into my next readathon, I will be doing the Royal Readathon, and this fits the prompt of Long Live the King, read a book with a male protagonist, and this is a dual POV between a male and a female, I believe. So this also fits that prompt. By the way, the Royal Readathon takes place from September 13th to the 20th. The next prompt for that readathon is May the Best Woman Win, read a book about a woman fighting for power. For that one, I chose Raybearer because just from the synopsis, I feel like at some point it's gonna be about this girl fighting for some type of power, whether it's her own or somebody else's. I know it's about a girl who was raised by like a goddess or a really powerful woman, and she is basically sent out to assassinate the prince, and I think that doesn't happen because she starts questioning the reasons behind this. So I'm very, very intrigued to see what happens in this. I've heard really good things. I've seen a lot of people love it. And honestly, the cover is just really pretty. Like, I love all the colors and everything. So exciting. All right, the next prompt is Who Run the World? Girls Read a Book Set in a Queendom. So for that one, I chose the first book in the Ruling Passions bind up, Hearts at Stake. So it's about a girl who lives in a world of vampires. She's one of the first female vampires born in a really long time. And the kingdom that they're set in, like the ruler of the vampires, I believe is a queen. So AKA a queendom. So this definitely fits. And this is really white. And then the last two prompts are gonna fit for this one book, and that is Bells Will Be Ringing, Read a Book Featuring a Romance, and then A Name Fit for a King, a book with a royal word in the title. So for that one, I chose You Should See Me in a Crown. This obviously features a romance, and crown is in the title, so it fits that last prompt. I need to finish this, basically, is what I'm saying, and so I'm throwing this in here so I can definitely finish it this month, because I hit a really bad slump last month, so I just was not really reading much of anything. But hopefully that will change this month and I can finally finish this and rave about it. All right, so the last readathon I'm going to be taking part in is Buzzwordathon, and I don't remember the date that takes place. I will put that down below when I edit this. But I believe the buzzword is night. So the book that I chose is Never Night by Jay Kristoff. I decided that it was probably time that I read this because it's been on my shelf for pretty much a year. And I want to see what all the hype's about. I want to see why people love this. And this is going to be actually for a special video I'm filming. And I'm going to be reading this for that video along with Jade City by Fonda Lee. And The Queen of the Tierling by Erica Johansson. Both of these books were recommended to me by Erin from Booked and Busy. I feel like she has just really good taste in books. So if you really like fantasy, adult fantasy, definitely check out her channel. But I'm hoping that I enjoy these because she recommended these. So these will also be what I will be reading for that video, these three books. So I'm really excited to film it. Hopefully I'm actually successful in filming it. If not, then we're probably not gonna talk about it again. And I will also be buddy reading House of Earth and Blood. I know I was supposed to finish it last month, but again, I hit a really bad reading slump and things were not read that were supposed to be read. But I will be buddy reading this with my friend Amber from Amber in a Face, and I'm so, so excited. So hopefully we can finish this, or at least get through like half of it or something before the end of the month. So yeah. And that is my September TBR for you all. I know these are a lot of books. Pray for me. I think I can at least get through a good number of them, if not all. So yeah, we'll see. If you liked the video, please like it down below. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, please leave all of those down below in the comment section. If you are not good at commenting, I'm gonna go ahead and say leave me an emoji down below. And if you want to see more videos from me, please subscribe down below. You are all sunflowers in a world full of weeds.